Hey everybody, look, I started building homes and buying land years ago, and it's been extremely profitable. The outreach of people that want to learn how to do it is unbelievable. Look, I just had a student this past week that came in and they're buying land right now to build a house. And one of the biggest things is the five factors that you need to take into account when you buy land and you build a home. And so, look, let's say for sake of example, you want to go in and you want to sell a house for $480,000. Now, where do you add up all your costs and what things are the most important factors? And so one of the big questions today, because of the hype of inflation that's really important to take into consideration, is who's going to pay for the cost of inflation? And so most people buying land and building houses, they sit back and they caution themselves and they say, look, I'm scared to be able to bite off the lumber increases, the concrete increases, the metal increases, the roofing increases, all the materials all the way down the line throughout construction. And so I halt them for a second. I say, look, for all the years that I've been in business, all the great entrepreneurs, business people, and business owners that I've been mentored by, I sit back and I'm going to explain to you guys today what each and every one of them has told me. I remember sitting down with Fred DeLuca, the founder of Subway. And when we owned tons of Subway stores, I sat down and they were talking about this hyperinflation of labor back in 2012, 2011, 2012. And I sat back thinking, okay, how are we going to afford the labor? We're already struggling financially on some of these stores that are very nominal. And if we have to pay more labor out to managers, to employees, to everybody all the way down the line, how are we going to be affected as a store? And I sat back and he goes, you know, Jerome, when I started selling Subways, he goes, we were selling them for 65 cents. He goes, and labor at that time was like $1.25 an hour. And he goes, we've just appreciated the price of the subs over the course of time and all of the chips and everything along with it. And so what I'm telling you guys with buying land, building a house, it's the exact same thing. And so one of the big things is making sure that you understand that if there's hyperinflation, it's not just you that has to account for it. It's every single builder. And so you take our nation's biggest builders. You take LGI Homes. You take D.R. Horton. You take Pulte. You take Toll Brothers. You take all these guys. Do you believe that they're absorbing the cost of lumber, materials for concrete, roofing, metal, and all of that stuff all the way down the line? Absolutely not. The end buyer absorbs all of that. And so this same house that you would be selling for $480,000, because of inflation, this house 2 years ago would be selling for $420,000. So for sake of example, if the lumber package for this house, which would normally cost under normal conditions about $35,000 for a lumber package on a $450,000 house, give or take, is now probably about $60,000-$65,000. So you take that cost increase and you pass it on to the end consumer. And so that same house that once was bought just a couple years ago for $420,000 is now a $480,000 house because of inflation. And so your profitability should also inflate with it as well. And so understand there's five factors that need to be taken into account so that you can go out and make a profit from buying land and building a house. Now look, how do you go in and assume an $80,000 to $100,000 profit on buying a lot and building a house? And so one of the big things, I'll sit back and I'll tell you guys, when you buy your land right. And so one of the reasons I got into developing land was to be able to have a lower acquisition price on my land. But I'll tell you that if you go in and you're building a $480,000 house, your lot price should be someplace in the neighborhood of about $80,000. It should never supersede $100,000. You supersede $100,000, now you're sitting in a position where your profits are coming out of your land price. Okay, and so under $100,000, someplace between, if you could pick up a lot closer to $65,000, your profitability is going to grow. If you're right around $80,000, your profitability is probably going to be right in the neighborhood of about $85,000 to $100,000 in profit. You get closer to $100,000 for the lot, you're going to probably be someplace in about an $80,000 profit plus or minus. So the land price, first thing to consider anytime you're going in and buying land and building a house. Second thing is the sales price based on comps in that area. What is the maximum amount that you're going to be able to sell a house for? Now, never go in assuming that you're going to make the comps in an area. Go in and assume that you're going to go in and complement the comps in an area. So the comparable homes that are selling in that vicinity, you want to be able to sit within that realm. And so if homes in that area are selling for between $450,000 and $550,000, then you're sitting in a cusp that is perfect for a business model of a $480,000 house. Now, what you need to do is look at the amenities, the trim out and the build and finish out items. And so that's all has to do with your build cost. So if your sales price is going to be $480,000 and your lot cost is going to be right around $100,000, now we know that we have $380,000 left to be able to build this house and also take out our profit margin. So that gives us about $250,000 in actual build cost. Okay, that's your footings, your concrete foundation, your framework, all your drywall, your insulation, your roofing, all your trim out items, your kitchen, your granite, your flooring, all your fixtures, your doors, all of it, $250,000. Now, can you do it? Now, the answer is yes, you can do it. And what can you maximize your trim outs to be at that $250,000 margin plus or minus? And so we sit back and we go in and we evaluate the finished trim outs of the houses next door. And believe it or not, having a good architect is worthwhile. Why? Because having a good architect can make or break the floor design of a house and the flow of how that house is actually functional. And so in early years, I remember sitting back and trying to do a lot of the design work myself. And when I did some of the design work myself, we did a good job in the beginning somewhat, right? But there's always flaws. And one of the big things is I made kitchens too small. I made closets too small. We made master bedrooms too small. Never too big, always too small. There's times we could have taken away from living areas to make kitchens slightly bigger. And so having a good architect is really good. But you learn over the years. And if you can learn, that's one of the biggest advantages in buying land and building a house. And so now what we do is we realize that people like taller ceilings. They like open, wide open floor plans. And they love to be able to have a wraparound floor plan where the whole house functions in a circle. For sake of example, they come in from their garage or they come in from their front door from two sides of the house. They can go through their kitchen, their master bedroom, their laundry room, their pantries, and everything circulates in the entire house. So we've learned that that's a big factor in being able to sell our homes because people just love the flow of our houses. So land cost. Sales price of your house, you're going to evaluate your comps, and then your build cost. That's number three. Number three is your build cost. And then you sit back and you say, okay, what are my costs of commissions, sales, title fees, architect fees? And you're going to have about $50,000 worth of costs and expenses on all your commissions to your buyer's broker, seller's brokers, your title fees, and all of your costs associated with building that house and all the services provided to be able to get that house from the build state to the sold state and then get your profitability. That gives you $80,000 remaining in profitability on that house. If you take a $100,000 build cost, you take a sales price of $480,000, you have a build cost of $250,000 and a commission cost of $50,000. Profitability, $80,000. Now, the way you get your build cost to function with that, so you can have your $80,000 profitability, is you go in and you reverse engineer it. We have a PDF that we've done that we've utilized for over 25 years on how to reverse engineer deals just like this. Buy a lot, build a house, reverse engineer all our expenses and costs. Because one of the biggest mistakes people make is they sit back and they go, Jerome, how do I evaluate all my costs? And if you've never done it before, the unknown is the unknown. And so how do you know what you don't know? And the way you know what you don't know is by working with people who know. And so by working with a team of professionals like ourselves, who've been exercising this stuff for years and years on end, understand that our costs and expenses might change as far as going up and down, but what is being charged doesn't change. And so by working with our team, having an exact guideline of what to plug in, what numbers to evaluate, and what to make sure you have as far as costs in regards to expenses for build costs are super important. And so understand that these five variables are the most important factors you need to consider when you're buying land and building a house. Look, if you like content just like this, you want more content like this, click and subscribe. The only thing that you need to do today is give us a big fat thumbs up if you like what you see. Join us for more information just like this, and I look forward to seeing you in the future.